I'm going to make a copy of our ODB01 employee database. And rename this to ODB06 employees form. And open that up. I'm going to go under the tables. And open up the table that we've already created. Looking at this data, it looks just like the spreadsheet, which is nice. We can see our top record, which has Mark Taylor, and it's easy to tell what the address, city, and state is. And even if we look at the very bottom one, Charles Miller, we can tell the address, city, and state. But if we're somewhere in the middle, maybe like Karen Robinson, when we get over to address and city, it's a little tricky to tell which field goes with which employee ID. There's an easier way to see the data one record at a time, and that's with a form. I'm going to close our table. Under our database window, I'm going to select forms. And we've got two choices here. We can create in design view or use the wizard to create a form. For now, we're going to use the wizard to create the form. We're going to come back to design view later on. This opens up our form wizard, and we've got the steps we need to complete to create our form on the left, and on the right are our options for that step. The first one is select a field, and we can select from a table or a query. We haven't gotten into queries yet, but we will. And we only have one table out there. That is our employees table. We've already seen the box like this one below, where we can select some or all of the fields and move them over to the right. I'm going to do the fast forward and select them all. And I'll go down to next. This is asking us if we want to set up a subform. We're going to come back to this one later on, but if we wanted to, we would check that box. Going to next skips us down to number 5, arrange controls. Gonna bring this down a little bit so we can see what it looks like. Here it's giving us some options to arrange the controls on the form. The default is as a data sheet, like our spreadsheet. And we've got a little spreadsheet view here, and here we can see what it would look like if we continued on with this form. If I click on the right, this is saying in blocks with the labels above. And here we see the fields and our labels above our fields. Another choice is columnar with labels on the left. Now it's a little difficult to tell, but you can see our one column here and our other column here. It's almost easier to tell the two columns. Our last choice is columnar labels left. Here we see all our fields lining up to the left, and all our labels are lined up to the left as well. When I select columnar labels left, we also have this other option of label placement. Here we've got it aligned left. Now I'm going to select align right. And we see when I change that, all our labels are now aligned right, or closer to the field that they're the label for. I'm going to leave this one selected. Going on to next. Select the data entry mode. I'm going to leave this as it is right now. But if we get the different choices, if I select this one, it would say data entry only, meaning you'd not be able to view any of the data that's on that table, but we could add a new record. Back with the form to display all data, now we can give the option of do not allow modification of any of the data in there. We can say you can't delete and you cannot add any records. In other words, with all these three checked, this form will only be allowed to view the data, but we can't make any changes to it. For now, I'm going to uncheck all these, and we're going to allow us to change the data, add another record, or delete a record if we like. Clicking next. Now we're down to apply styles. We've got the 3D look as the default. I can say no borders, and we can see what it looks like there with no borders. Flat borders. I like the 3D look. We can also pick our choice of background colors. We're not limited to these background colors, and we'll look at that in a future tutorial. For now, we're just going to select one of our default backgrounds, and I'm going to pick ice blue. Our last option is to give our form a name. Now, back in the old days, we used to want to start this with FRM for form employees to differentiate that from our table employees, which we would label as TBL employees. But the way that LibreOffice divides things up, I'm going to leave that off and just leave this as employees. Now we can either work with the form or modify the form. I'm going to leave this as work with the form and click finish. If you don't see any data, you had the wrong checkbox checked and it brought you into edit mode. To get out of that, close your form and open it back up by double clicking. Now we should all have the same thing open, and we can see that we are at employee ID 0. If we come down, we've got this navigation toolbar. If you don't see that, go into View, Toolbars, Form Navigation, and make sure that that's turned on, because this is going to help us get around our database. We can click onto the next record. Here's 2, 3, 4, and this is our employee ID. Now in this case, we just happen to have our employee ID match up with the record number, but these are two different numbers. This is the number of records on the table, and this is the unique number that we gave to our employee. And in this case, they just happen to match. But if we delete one or add one, they could get out of sync. So we can't say that this record number is the same as the employee ID. They're different numbers. We can jump to the last record. We can jump to the first record. If we want to add a record, we can hit the new record here, or we can go to our last record and click on next. And that takes us to the same thing as add a new record. Now the auto value, we don't need to take care of that. We would just type in the rest of the information. If we want to change some data on here, let's say instead of the address is Birch, we're going to call this Birch Tree. So now Charles Miller lives at 3579 Birch Tree. Going to the previous record and back shows us that it's now updated. Let's go back to the first record, which our employee ID is 0 and our record number is 1. So they're off there. Now we got 2 is matching up to 2. 3 is matching up to 3, but I'm going to delete record 3 just by clicking on the X. It's asking us to confirm that we want to delete this. I say yes. And now our employee ID number will be different than our record number. So it will be one off. This is pretty good, makes it easy to find things, but what if we have 100, 200, 1,000 records? How do we quickly find one? We come over here to this magnifying glass. Clicking on that, this brings up a search box. We could put in this case, we've got employee ID. If we want to find employee ID number 10, click search. And it brings us to employee ID 10. I'm going to make this 20. Click 20. Let's say we want to find all the employees whose first name starts with D. I'm going to change our where to search to first name. Clicking it one time shows that we have a Sandra, because I say anywhere in the text field. I didn't clarify this. I want this to start with, so I want to say at the beginning of the field. Now I should find the next person in the table that's first name starts with D. And we've got Donald Thompson. If I click it again, we've got Daniel Harris. A third time, now we've got David Brown. So we have at least 3. If I click this again, we've got Donna Lee, 4. And then we're back to Don Thompson. Now there's more things we can do with these settings, and this field contains null. We'll talk about this in future tutorials. But for now, we've got a basic idea of how to create a simple form and how to search that form for a specific record.